battle is unpredictable, as is life. Every battle is an opportunity, right, General?
Who wouldn't want to buy a slightly more hospitable environment? Investment, brother. I believe your target's on the battlefield there. Careful, brother. You're covered in Bifrost. Go! should be able to make our way up now. Ready?
I'm back! What a thrill! killing frenzy. Don't hurry up and make a decision on my account. Heading back to the cage, are we? I guess Valhalla is giving you a second chance. Harp! Well, now it's a party. Incoming dive! That's right, for sure! Incoming right side! What are you planning to do this time, Kratos? Wait, no, don't tell me. The suspense is honestly the only thing keeping me awake. Here's a radical thought for you. Maybe it only counts as a sacrifice if you give up someone you value. I think we all know that's not me.
Quiet, Nobita.
Cyclops! You'll never guess their weak spot. Brilliant move you've thought of. Kratos? Surely you're not supposed to.
You know what?
Oh, where are we now? Tyr.
The invitation was yours.
I would have signed it, but it was important you come here for your own reasons.
Then you're not an illusion.
You're in the flesh, old friend.
What do you want?
I know what you're wrestling with, Spartan. I understand it better than you realize. The shame. The doubt. The question I could find no answer for until I came here. Lifetimes ago. Stepped through that door.
What is in there?
Oh. I'm not here to spoil that for you. Only to help you prepare.
Why?
Because I can. Because for us, fighting occupies the body, while our minds work out the rest. Because you're not ready. Yet.
Show me.
Sorry, why exactly are you attacking us?
Consider it a kind of trial by combat, Mimir. When Kratos can get the better of me, we'll know his mind has done the work. Definitely done, Kratos. An attack of Olympian power. Impressive. Remember, it isn't supposed to be easy.
Very good, very good. Not your death just now, but all the progress you made.
You must strike a balance between discipline and creativity.
Suppose that was beneficial enough to do another.
Legends are made and remade.
Bargain away, brother. Valhalla expects it.
Well fought, General. You made much better progress that time.
Sigrun, it's good to see you back.
Freya was just being cautious. I'm right as rain. How fares your journey?
We have uncovered our host. It is Tyr.
Tyr, you say?
Aye. And no projection, either.
I never knew his connection to Valhalla was so strong. But then, he goes back further than I do. Fascinating.
Before you ask, yes, I was back in the Old Forest again. And this time I encountered my former boss, King Oberon. Rather eye-opening, actually. I used to be a true believer for him. Would have done anything he asked. But now I see through all that charisma and feigned wisdom down to the small, hypocritical tyrant I know him to be. Wait till I tell you what he put me up to regarding a particular magical flower.
To tell a story of your first master.
Aye. It seems to be the very story Valhalla has me reliving, in fact. Oberon fancied himself a romantic, you see. Always claimed that love was more important to him than anything. One time, he led his entire entourage on a journey to attend the wedding of some duke or other, near your old neck of the woods. The groom, this lordly prick, had conquered a warrior queen and was marrying her as part of terms for peace. And this, somehow, was so romantic to Oberon that he dragged us across the sea to pay respects. Never mind, he was quarreling with his own queen the entire way! Well, I'll have more of that one, to be sure.
Ah! Ah! Fire cross everywhere!
As I was saying about my old master and his lofty, so-called romantic ideals, we'd settled in a forest outside of Athens, a place well situated to observing the comings and goings of the Duke's other guests. There we observed the romantic complications of some local youths, and Oberon gets it into his head to intervene, bids me fetch him a magical flower that can manipulate the affections of others. Supposedly, the idea was to nobly help true love prevail over the pressure of family arrangements. But what he really wanted was to use the flower to torment his own wife.
I see why you left his service.
Aye.
Watch your left!
The one Valhalla singled out for you.
Right side.
the one you needed.
Excellent. The way should be clear. Up and onward. So, we've got to beat that one, and still have strength enough to go further? All right, we can do that.
Learning is a lifelong journey, no mere destination. Take that. Valhalla is a crucible. What will you become? The elite enemies Valhalla has chosen for you to target will only continue to manifest. You must adapt and employ all available resources, or you will fall again.
Sigrun, how fare you and your sisters?
With just the three of us to attend to the Fallen now, we're short-handed. But we've begun recruiting new Shield Maidens.
Well, I happen to know of one lass who'd jump at the chance to join your ranks.
You mean Thrud? Sif and Thor's daughter? Believe me, I know. She sought us out before the call even left our lips.
She fights well, and can be trusted.
A recommendation from you, General. With that, how could we ignore her? Not that she'd let us.
Brother, while I'd love to say I left Oberon's service as a matter of principle, the truth is it was much more a question of pride. If he'd simply shown me more appreciation, who knows how long I might have tolerated his evils. I certainly tolerated plenty from my subsequent employers before I could take no more. If I'm being honest, I was only too happy to offer my complicity in Queen Titania's humiliation.
What did you do?
I caused her to fall in love with something preposterous. And...
Master, he had you make his wife fall in love with another.
Aye, temporarily, by use of this magic flower. Though now it's clear to me the flower's effect isn't love, exactly, but a kind of obsessive devotion that is too often mistaken for love. So, of course, the Queen made a fool of herself. As did all those under the flower's spell that night. I don't know how I ever got embroiled in such a farce.
You are wiser now.
I think so. Though that only makes up for so much past stupidity.
Yes, sir!
Use our shield
Excellent. The way should be clear. Up and onward.
if I have any advice, I think it's high time to invest in some personal upgrades.
To adapt is to lean into the alchemy of turning adversity into advantage.
It's encouraging to know Valhalla wants to help. That'll be worth it.
It is all too common to fall to one of the chosen enemies of Valhalla. Don't lose heart.
Sigrun, dear, as Kratos and I have been off the beaten path, so to speak, I'm curious as to the state of the realms.
Well, since my sisters and I returned to our old Valkyrie duties, the souls of the damned no longer find the gates of Helheim closed to them. So...
No more Hellwalkers spilling into the other realms? Grand!
I can't say no Hellwalkers are left in the realms, but there are fewer. Rasvelger seemed pleased. Or at least I think that's what her expression meant.
What for? Thank you.
Behind you! Go!
There's the one Valhalla's marked. Watch your left.
Watch your left!
up should be clear now, whenever you're ready.
Hard not to take Valhalla up on some help, even if...
Ah!
Hello again, Kratos. Oh, I meant to ask. How did you like setting yourself on fire? Truly entertaining stuff. Sorry to miss how it ended up. I think maybe you still have some ash on your skin. Am I crazy?
Great.
However you died just now,
I blame Helios.
Those who adapt are not bound by circumstance.
Better yourself if and when you can, I always say.
Valhalla selects your opponents for a reason. Embrace the challenge, but know you can prevail.
Milady, how is Alfheim these days? Does the peace hold?
It's tenuous, but holding. Endless war tends to breed quite a bit of mistrust. Thankfully, the elves, Bela and Bigvir, are in positions of influence due to their association with Freyr and involvement in Ragnarok. It's the best chance at lasting peace the realm has ever had.
What about the findings in the Consul's journal? Have they shared it with the rest of the elves?
Not yet, but give them time.
Hmph!
Boost this time around, maybe.
Yeah.
Sigalak!
Now then, be unlocked. Let's make our way up. Well, that brute was exceptionally difficult. I hope you stick it out.
The pursuit of mastery demands the willingness to embrace failure. Often, without judgment. I'm honored to bear witness to your journey here, Kratos.
No shame in making things a wee bit easier if you can.
Valhalla selects your opponents for a reason. Embrace the challenge, but know you can prevail.
Sigrun, I've been wondering. Are the remaining Vanir and Aesir playing nice in Vanaheim?
The Asgardian relocation hasn't exactly been smooth sailing, but Hilda Svini and Lady Sif are keeping the ship headed in the right direction. The people seem to understand compromise is their best path to prosperity, at least.
Truth be told, I was hoping the old boar would have to call on me to smooth things over, but it's good to hear he and Sif have it under control.
Freya hopes they'll join the council once the peace settles.
Behind you! Look out!
Could use some limited time assistance, couldn't we?
Above you! Watch out!
Should be unlocked now, shall we?
Oh!
You're not done with me yet, Kratos.
Dead, you've made them.
only getting harder as you delay, Kratos.
Welcome, Kratos. Honor me with another sparring match.
And we're back to fighting.
Kratos will win this fight when he is ready for what lies beyond.
Mind you, watch out!
The valor to go the distance, I hope. There it is. That's it. Be ready. Oh,
When you're ready, you'll know.
Admittedly, I did not imagine getting killed by Tyr would be part of the process here.
You must turn complexity into simplicity. This is the essence of mastering Valhalla.
And the wheel of progress turns.
Valhalla salutes you.
Guna.
A gift. Valhalla appreciates every step of your evolution.
A chance to bargain with Valhalla itself. Progress, right there.
You must admire Tyr's skill after so long in captivity. But don't hold back.
Sigrun, love, what's the latest on Midgard?
Life returns at last. After the Hellwalker desolation was followed by Fimbulwinter, I wondered if people would ever come out of hiding, or if there were any left to. But flowers bloom, the sun shines, and it's safe to travel the roads and rivers again. No one even seems to mind the giant serpent sunning himself across the mountaintops.
Glad to hear it. Jormungandr's a big softy when you get to know him.
And now that things aren't quite so desperate, raider attacks have declined. It's progress.
brother. You're covered in Vibron.
Maybe just for this try, but a little assist would be nice.
There's the one Valhalla singled out for you. Watch your right.
Splendid. I think we're free and clear to take the way up now.
Thank you.
I'm back to brighten your day. Decisions. Soaked in savage ways.
brother. I'm back.
Hello again, Kratos.
A deficit upon his focus. He is impatient, emotional, easily surprised. A man at one with himself has a clearer mind, sharper instincts. That man is ready to win. That man is ready to progress.
Incoming! Above you!
That time.
defend yourself. Well done, Kratos. I yield.
Good then.
Perhaps you are ready now.
Am I?
Honestly, nobody can truly say that but you.
Get you there.
You're saying you sent the invitation in the first place?
Yes. And look, I think Kratos may have survived that time.
So it's Tyr's game you're playing? This is all his idea?
The game is not his purpose. There is something here I must see through.
And what is that exactly?
A process.
All right. If it's helping, I trust you both.
We all do. As we trust in Valhalla.
Even after what it did to you?
I knew the rules and chose to break them. I regret nothing. You are proving yourself.
We did more things and more things to do. Check.
There.
Take this. Do you feel adaptability sharpening your skills? Amplifying your power? I'll tell you more of my story now, if you care to hear it.
Proceed.
If you remember, my father had fallen ill. It was bad. An illness unknown to us. I offered to fetch the mage healer from the city, but my father refused. He insisted herbs were the only way to help him. You can guess what happened next. He was gone before the spring. I was devastated. In time, I grew to hate my father's philosophy and dedicated myself to healing through magic. It was a blind rejection of an entire field because I believed it failed my father. Because I blamed his death on his faith. The truth is, I traded one limiting perspective for another, but I wasn't ready to see that yet. That's a good place to stop for now.
Thank you.
You've been busy.
Shield Maiden.
This is for you. Each accomplishment is a stepping stone to further greatness. Ready for a little more of my life story?
Continue.
I was in the fight of my life with the thugs who burned down my father's inn. Suddenly, there's this sound, this flapping of feathers, and who should appear but Sigrun herself. Not yet queen, but by reputation, the best fighter the Valkyries had in memory. I was awestruck. She was confused. The violence, the mayhem she sensed, she expected to follow to a battlefield full of honored dead, not a hideout in the slums. I apologized to her for not sending worthier souls to Valhalla, and Sigrun offered to take me under her very impressive wing. But we'll cover that part next time, all right?
I know it's above board, but I like to think of this part as bribing the local authorities.
Kratos. I'm glad to see you're back inside. It seems Valhalla has arranged something special for you in the throne room. See you again soon, Kratos.
This.
You remember this, Kratos. The memory is vivid, a familiar scene to any that know your legend. A man at the crossroads of a fateful decision.
Aye, you've spoken of this, brother. The pact you made with Ares, to stave off the barbarian horde.
The day I sold my soul to a god of war. Why show me this?
Well, I had to guess. Probably to make you feel like the piece of shit you are.
Is he necessary?
He's no part of my design. He's either Valhalla's or yours.
At least he hasn't replaced me again.
Not yet, anyway. Seems a real charmer. A memory fragment of your time in Alfheim, then.
Tell me, who was Kratos of Sparta the day you made your pledge to Ares?
I was the youngest captain in the Spartan army. I had gained a reputation for my skills in combat, my command on the battlefield, but also my aggression. I was determined to never lose, and until then, never had. My men were loyal, fiercely so.
How many Spartans did you command?
Not enough that day.
How many barbarians did you face?
Thousands.
coming! Above you!
Dear, why help prepare me to take your old position? Why not fulfill it yourself? You seem capable.
To the mortals of these realms, I am an ancient myth, long out of mind. The days I could hope to unify these realms are long past. But they see you as the rather. You are known and respected. And from what I have seen, you're the most qualified by far. You need only be ready.
Well, this is an unusual little corner of Valhalla, isn't it? Shall we see what else we can find in here? Careful. Who knows what's waiting for you in that mess? I think we're meant to choose one chest or the other. Shall we have a look?
reactor's about to explode!
What the fuck? See the one you need to get there!
Hey, no, on the left!
Shield strike, brother!
Ha! I knew you'd get that one. Path should be unlocked now, shall we? We're rid of that little cuss.
Meet once more, Ghost of Sparta.
I must say, it's genuinely hard to think of anything stupider than pledging your soul to Ares of all people. I mean, any of Zeus's brood are bound to be garbage, present company by no means excluded. But Ares made a real art out of being vicious and depraved. Though, I suppose I can't begrudge you your role model. I see you still use the blades he gave you. Can you really say you regret a decision? And still keep benefiting from the trappings of that decision? I'm not sure, I'm jealous. You ever try to do the math on how many people died as a result of your little collaboration? Like contemplating the grains of sand on a beach, isn't it? Just overwhelming, honestly.
That.
Looks like someone left you a party favor. Oh, and it's a symbolic totem of your shame.
That's so thoughtful.
Ah, now you've done it. You're being judged. And we all know your past actions wouldn't pass muster with anybody.
Oh!
watching you think? What a thrill.